Good afternoon, Namaskar. I, Kriti Vadhera, would like to welcome all the teachers, learners, educators, students to CIET NCERT's live phone-in program. And you are watching us live on PME Vidya's channel number 10. This session will be for Standard 10 students. Social science is the subject which we will be discussing in the next 30 minutes for you. And we will be having a very interesting discussion on MNREGA Act. We will be knowing it and in all the possible details. And the expert who is joining us today for this particular interaction, I would like to introduce you to all, Professor M. Srinivasan from Department of Education and Social Sciences. I welcome you, Professor Srinivasan.
Thank you.
And before we start with this interesting discussion, viewers, I would like to remind you here that if you have any kind of questions and suggestions, then please do let us know. You can dial on our toll-free number to tell us. Number would be 8800440559. If you want to watch this program on YouTube, then please log into NCERT's official YouTube channel. And there also in the live chat box, you may send all your suggestions and questions to us. One more medium to contact us, kindly mail all your suggestions and questions to dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. So these are the various mediums to contact us and send your suggestions and questions. Now we shall begin this interesting session on MNREGA Act. I welcome you again, Professor Srinivasan. Although I have also heard about this act various times, but is it really important for 10th class and these, you know, youngsters to know this act? How important it is? What all it is all about?
Kirti, let me first thank CIET for giving this opportunity, and my dear parents, students, teachers and other viewers. We all know that as a person who has graduated or who have done technical qualifications, we used to go to big cities and towns for registering ourselves in employment offices in cities and towns. But do you know that we do have employment office in the villages and 250,000 grama panchayats in all over India? Are you interested in, if you are living in a rural area, if your family is wanting some job, if you want to get some at least 15 days, 20 days or some amount of job for your family because of due to various reasons, is it possible in India? It is possible because the Gram Panchayat functions as a mini employment office. If you want to know about this employment office, mini employment office in the rural parts, then you should know about MNREGA. That's a kind of act, the unique in the whole world. No country in the world has a law which says that people can go and demand a job and the government has to give a job for at least 15 days and to the maximum 100 days. In that sense, it is an important topic we all should know.
Right.
Second reason is that most of you listening to my English presentation, you may be living in cities and towns and you may not be aware about something happening in the rural area. So for a person who is living in the urban area, if you want to know about the mini employment offices, how the government is trying to ensure the right to work for people, then we should know about MNREGA. That's the second reason. Third reason, this is the one topic which gives you an interdisciplinary approach. Learning social sciences using economic dimensions such as employment, geography, the employment in the rural areas in different parts, and then history, and then political science, because it is an act which is implemented by the various forms of various organs of the government. So political science, so all the four subjects including history, all the four subjects are involved in this act. That's why we all have to get familiarized with the some nuanced aspects of the MNREGA Act.
Wonderful, right.
That's the first one. You may be wondering why suddenly how this act came into being. So look at the screen. This is called combine harvester. In 1993, I went to a small village in Tamil Nadu where I was doing a survey. And in the early mornings, I went to a farm where I noticed that this combine harvester was used by the farmers. This is called a combine because it also harvest paddy, it can also harvest wheat and other grains,
okay.
And it can also thresh and make it to bags. You just have to go and carry your bag, and then it will give you a pad here.
So it's a multi-purpose machine.
It's a multi-purpose machine. And I noticed that some almost about 100 agricultural laborers were looking at this machine with huge sorrow, pain in their eyes. Why? Because this machine has displaced hundreds and thousands of people in the rural India.
Right.
For example, this machine will harvest paddy 1 acre, not 1 acre, 5 acre in 1 hour. 5 acre in 1 hour.
1 hour.
Whereas it will take 5 days and at least 10 employees for 4 days. If the 10 agricultural laborers work for 5 days and then continuously work for like in the field, then they can harvest. So that means every 1 hour you can see how many people are getting unemployed.
Unemployed, right.
Many studies have shown in the last 3 decades that employment is not growing in the country, particularly the rural area. Population grows every year, whereas the employment is not growing. So having realized this, and the wages are also not rising, having realized this very sad state of affairs in the post-globalized India, post-reform India, at the time the government of India enacted this law and approved by the Indian Parliament. That's how this act came into being. You see, who are the people who were displaced by this machine? The harvesters. It is not only the combined harvester. Look at the tractor. If you go today, particularly in the big, very farm areas, this tractor has displaced plowing machines. 40 years before, 80% of the all the work, the machine work, were done by the human beings. But today, it's hardly 20% only.
With the help of cattle, we can see.
So cattle's jobs have gone now, and the farmers' jobs have gone now. Agricultural laborers' jobs have gone now. So most of the jobs in the rural area are getting disappearing.
Right.
So in order to address this issue, and also what will happen if there is no employment in the rural area, people will be coming to urban
cities.
And if they are not able to learn the skills of working with the cities, and the situation would be very very sad actually. That is why the government of India in 2005 enacted this law. Okay. So you may be seeing, what is this law about? If you are living in a rural area, look at this kind of symbol with a stone written on the concretes. This means the MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, is implemented in this area. And this board also, I am going to explain one by one. It contains many details about the feature of the MNREGA. The name of the work is mentioned there. Estimated amount of budget is mentioned there. Wages details, material details. I am going to come back this particular slide in the screen again and again. I'll tell you then, so that it will help us to understand the features of the MNREGA. What are the features? You may be interested. Please do understand that this is not a scheme. There is a difference between the scheme and an act. A scheme means any government, central government, state government, then they can come, they formulate a scheme and they implement it actually. That's called scheme. And if the government goes, there is no surety that the same scheme will be implemented. Whereas MNREGA is an act. If the act is not implemented, people can go to court, demand that this act should be implemented in their area. Number one. Number two, this is the only act in the whole world, as I told you earlier, that in which people can demand that I want a job for 15 days. And the Gram Panchayat has to arrange, first register his name or her name. And then within 15 days, he or she has to be given a job card, something called job card. It's like an identity card any employer would issue. After giving the job card, by 15 days time, he or she should be given a job, invited for a job. And if it is not, he is not invited, then he will be given an unemployment pension. It's called not pension, unemployment allowance actually. So this is an act which can be taken by the court. People can go and demand for a job. That is the relevance of this act. That's why we all have to know about this act. So what is the first feature of this act? I already told you that it came out in 2005. The main purpose is to reduce poverty and migration. We all know that during the COVID regime, almost like 5 crore people, this is the estimated number of the migrants in the country.
Right.
And see, the government enacted by this law, by this act, it can reduce the migration of people from rural to urban area. Okay, so that's these, by generating rural employment. Generating employment means people can go do some job, rural, very unskilled job. Secondly, who can get job? Any adult member, whether educated, uneducated, never mind, you can go and ask for a job at the Gram Panchayat. And there are already 2.5 lakh Gram Panchayats in the country. They issue, as I told you, job card. And then as a citizen, as a Gram Panchayat member, after the issuing of job card, you can tell them that when you want a job and where you want a job, for how many days you want a job. That's also duration
and
time.
That's also given, okay.
That is also mentioned actually.
Right.
And then within 15 days time, the GP, Gram Panchayat, or the NGOs, self-help groups, which were already approved by the Gram Panchayats, which have jobs, they have to invite you with the job card to give you a job. And the work also to be given within the 5 kilometers radius of the village. If it is beyond 5 kilometers, then they should be paid transport allowances. And then in this job, more and more labor has to be used, less and less machinery has to be used.
Okay.
So that people who are displaced by the machinery in the rural area can get job. That's the purpose. And the particularly, this is an empowering instrument for women. More and more women should be employed. There is a statement in the act itself. That's why you will find in many states, more and more women are employed in this job. And then money is the major issue in the existing earlier schemes before 2005 is that money was given in the form of cash or kind actually. There's a huge lot of corruptions. Whereas in the Manrega, money is not given to you in your hand. It is deposited in your post office by the government. So there is no middleman who can take away your money. That's the another important feature of the this act. And as I told you earlier, that if the employment is not provided by Gram Panchayat in 15 days time, they will have to provide you unemployment allowance and whatever it was decided by the state government. Then in the work site, the safety has to be ensured by the Panchayat. Drinking water, safe drinking water has to be provided. And then if there are women coming with the children, there should be some shade to be given and first aid box are provided. If there is any injury, the expenses should be borne by the Gram Panchayat or the program officer who is working on the particular work site. And if there is any disability or death, they will be paid about 2 lakh rupees as part of the Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana insurance scheme. And this scheme is funded by the both state government and central government. Union government bear the 90% expenses and 10% is borne by the state government. So these are some of the important features. Look at this video. So if you look at the video, you will see the it is a video recently published by the Ministry of Rural. We'll be right back.
Professor Srinivasan, we just witnessed that it was a very recent one. Post-COVID things were also, the figures were mentioned. Yeah. So how was this act this implemented?
So this scheme is recently, the video that you have seen is recently published by the brought out by the Ministry of Rural Development. And during the COVID-19 regime, the government has spent a lot of money so that it can reach out to the people in the rural area who were affected by the lockdown and the COVID-19. So you may be wondering how this scheme is functioning, how it is functioning in the country. Look at the screen. If you look at the screen, you will find the different agencies' names were there, and there is also a circle. So the scheme starts from the Gram Panchayat. So Gram Panchayat, if you are living in the rural area, if you are living in a particular village, that particular village Gram Panchayat decides for the next year how many days of employment may be required for our people. It decides. And then it plans, it conducts many meetings, and it sends the proposal to the block level panchayat. There a government program officer is located. So he is given the proposal that how many days of employment will be required in that particular Gram Panchayat. From the program officer of the block level panchayat, it is getting approved, and from there many blocks come together, and then they come to the district panchayat. Third, the violet color one. So district program officer and the district panchayat leader, who is supposed to be a collector, they will be holding the meeting, they will finalize the scheme. And finally, it comes to the state government. And within the state government, they look at the entire budget of all the districts in the state. And then from there, the proposals go to the Ministry of Rural Development of the Union Government. From the Union Government, again, it comes back to this circle, comes back to Gram Panchayat. Because if you are interested in more details about the website, how go to the website of MNREGA. NREGA.NIC.IN. You will get the details about how this Ministry of Rural Development works with the MNREGA. So these are the circle through which this comes from Union Government. Again, it goes to the Gram Panchayat, because again the flow starts from Gram Panchayat only. That's how the organizations from the Gram Panchayat to the Union Government, all the wings are functioning for implementing this MNREGA Act. You may be wondering, what is this? This is called job card. And this job card tells you that what is the number, the person, this I collected from somebody in Tamil Nadu, and the person name, age, gender, and then which category, SC, ST, OBC, the caste name is there, when was the card was issued actually, and what is the address of the person, and then this card, job card was issued by the Gram Panchayat. On the right hand side, you can see the signature of the Gram Panchayat leader. So this is called a job card. If you look at what are the other unique features? I already told you that this is called in economics demand driven. People can demand a job and the government has to provide the job. That means you demand a job and then government generate employment for you. And secondly, this has lot of monitoring purposes. Many monitoring mechanisms were evolved, which are highly democratic, nowhere you can see in the world this kind of mechanisms. What are those job mechanisms are there? Every Gram Panchayat has to prepare the monthly progress report of the employment happening in their village. Secondly, there is something called social audit. Every Gram Panchayat also has to conduct social audit of what kind of work that took place. Secondly, thirdly, if there is any problem, for example, if the wages were not paid, or if there is under employment or underpaid wages, if there is any issue, people can write to Gram Panchayat or any part of these five circles, and then through the social audit, there will be a public hearing. In the public hearing, all the officers will be invited along with the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Sabha plays very crucial role in conducting the social audit. In that social audit, it is not that the officers, the government employees, the government officers, or the Gram Panchayat people will be there. It is the people from universities, colleges, educated, like many highly educated people, along with the people who work in the civil society organization like NGOs, they will be conducting the social audit. It's almost like a public hearing where people come and show, like express their grievances.
Right.
That's how the monetary mechanisms are formulated in the MNREGA. You may be like the other thing is that the what are the kind of work you must have seen in that 5-minute video, what kind of work going on in the MNREGA.
Right.
The major work is the water conservation. If time permits, we will see a very good video how a barren land becomes a greenery. So the water conservation is the major activity in the MNREGA work. And the second one is drought proofing. That means if there is a drought like situation and government has to go there and support with MNREGA jobs. So it may be like many irrigation kind of irrigation related work, plantation, horticulture, land development work, and then tanks. There are many hundreds and thousands of tanks, like tanks in the country, and renovation of tanks, and then flood control measures. So you can see many such things happening. If you are rural in rural area, please yes. visit a MNREGA site and see what kind of works going on there. And you can develop a report based on it as
but
part of your
social. I can see from top to bottom all the activities which were performed were somehow balancing this ecological disbalance in the society, right? Yes.
I'm coming to that point. What are the like major impact of this work? I'll come back like in a few minutes actually. Rural connectivity. So if there is a rain and it happens that the rural roads gets washed away.
Drained
so, MNREGA also includes rural roads building, rural sanitation. For example, Swachh Bharat, under Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, many toilets were
toilets
built
were made,
all
yeah.
over. The, and part of those work, the MNREGA will provide you labor.
Right.
MNREGA will bear the labor cost.
Right.
That could be one major component of MNREGA.
MNREGA.
And then construction of houses, particularly government has like Indira Awas Yojana, many house building schemes were there in the state by the state and central government. And if there are construction of houses for the individual also, and the MNREGA will provide you labor. That's the major component in the like, that's the important component of MNREGA. You may be wondering, what is this shows? What is the purpose? What is the impact? Because in 2005 means now it is 15 years have gone. What is the major impact of the MNREGA? The major impact that one can see, many studies, I have gone through some of the research studies conducted on the MNREGA impact all over India. They point out 7 components. These are the 7 components. Women empowerment. Traditionally, in the rural area, women are paid much less than men actually. In
yeah.
the MNREGA, whoever is getting employed, they will get equal wages. So the MNREGA has become like equalizer, levelizing, level playing field by giving equal wages for both men and women in the work site. And also because majority of the workers are women and the entire incomes, they go to their house, their own children and for their own health and education purposes. And they, it's also decision making, who is taking the decision in the house. So when women go and earn their bread and butter, and the decision making in the house also changes. So it leads to, many studies are showing that women empowerment has been strengthening in the rural area because of the MNREGA. And secondly, reduced migration. In the initial years, we also noticed that thousands of workers who used to, I'm just giving you one example from Bihar to Punjab. After the implementation of MNREGA, the migration has reduced considerably. That's studies have shown, not only from Bihar to Punjab, even other areas also. Thirdly, it led to creation of durable assets, buildings, houses, toilets, roads. So durable assets were created by the because of the MNREGA. Food security, because the families are able to buy food grains. That's the major impact of the MNREGA. Building infrastructure, roads, many other buildings like renovation of tanks, that led to building of infrastructure also. Sustainable development, as you were also mentioning that it led to water conservation, means you have more and more trees, you have more and more like water available for drinking purposes, you have a clean drinking water.
Right.
And then supports farmers. In many areas, watershed dams, mini dams, earthen dams
yeah.
were built. So that means the farmers are getting support from the MNREGA.
Right.
These are the 7 impact one can see from the like MNREGA.
Professor Srinivasan, with this we are entering into the last minutes of today's interaction. I feel it has to be along
there
the
are,
way.
Yeah. Okay.
Just last few minutes left.
See, the idea that the you may be thinking that I am showing only the greeneries of the MNREGA. There are many challenges. If you look at the screen, these challenges are listed here. So the Mandrake also has a lot of challenges for which the lack of awareness is very important. Okay. So the, we have to create awareness about the Mandrake, and we have to address the issue of corruption, underutilization of funds, non-payment of wages, absence of social audits. There's a long way to go to make this law enacted, implemented effectively. For that, you as a student and as a parent, as a teacher, need to know more about it. Visit the Mandrake Gram Panchayat and see that how it is implemented in the rural area. This, my presentation is over. And
we can have another presentation by you somehow later when we can discuss in more detail about the effective implementation and the problems which people must have faced. And yes, in cities we cannot see this act being implemented. So that is also a challenge.
Yeah, so it's not implemented in urban area because the major purpose here is that the generating rural employment, because if the urban is nothing but the migration of people from rural area. So
right.
That's the reason why, the government at the time was envisaging a scheme for urban India also, hope that in the coming decades it will come.
Okay. So this is what Mandrake is all about. Anything in last few minutes if you want to share with our viewers about this particular act itself?
Yeah, the one thing that if you are a student living in the urban area, talk to the migrants who are living, doing some work in urban areas. Talk to them and ask them that when there is a Mandrake scheme in the rural area, why they migrated to the urban area. That's the first question. Second question, if you are living in the rural area, please visit the Gram Panchayat and talk to the details about how the Mandrake is implemented in your Gram Panchayat. And talk to the members of the Gram Panchayat and attend the Gram Sabha meetings, because that's where the Mandrake is conceived, in every Gram Panchayat.
Professor Srinivasan, that is the suggestion to the children who are watching us countrywide and are in village somehow. But the children who are in cities and urban areas, what is your suggestion to them if they want to study in detail about this act?
There are very interesting videos available in the YouTube. I can show you if you look at the screen. I'm just showing some of the names. You just go to the YouTube and just type Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. If you look at, I'm just showing the screen some of the details, like some of the videos published by the Down to Earth and videos published by the Ministry of Rural Development. There are about very good, very interesting videos available over there, and you can see their impact. So this is one way you can understand, you can develop better understanding about how the Mandrake is implemented in India.
So while sitting inside homes itself, they can have a look that what all is being done under Mandrake Act, right?
In fact, it is possible that nearby rural area they can visit. That's the second option I can suggest. Once the corona, the lockdown, all the issues are over, and I would request them, please visit a nearby rural area. Every state, even Delhi has some rural area. Even Delhi also is implementing Mandrake. So students, you can visit a rural part and then see the Mandrake, how it is implemented.
And of course, you can click pictures like Professor Srinivasan just showed, that all the possible details will be given wherever the Mandrake site is. So pictures you can click and you can of course share with us. And this was about Mandrake Act, viewers. I thank Professor Srinivasan for joining us today.
Thank you.
And remain connected, class 10 students, because we will be bringing a mathematics session for you in next session. So remain connected. We are coming back just in a short while. Thank you.